Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded a slight price, I would say, decline for the last 24 hours, or this is just some kind of intraday correction. But in my view, if we take into account the broader picture, we know that after a solid price increase, probably some kind of consolidation is taking place now. So we're moving, let's say the cryptos are moving in some kind of broad range. And that's why I would say that this is just some kind of consolidation. Of course, some cryptos like Polkadot, for example, Cardano, Chainlink, they continue to increase, but they've been quite good performers recently. And they were among the best performers among the, let's say, the top 10 or 15 cryptos for the last year, for the year of 2020. That's why probably they continue to increase in price. But anyway, I would say that the crypto market has been doing really amazingly well for the last, let's say, year or two. And actually, since inception, to be honest, because of course we sometimes have these bear markets, but it's just part of the game. What I want to say is, of course, now when the crypto has surpassed $1 trillion of a market cap, Bitcoin is hitting $30,000-$40,000 per one a digital coin. Many new people, they start to hear or to get interested into cryptocurrencies. And I want to say that earlier today in the morning, I met some friends. We had a cup of coffee. Most of them are still not in the cryptocurrency world, but they continue to ask questions about crypto, about Bitcoin, about the price, how sustainable it is it a good investment instrument, and etc. And I want to say that I also have many friends online with whom I stay in contact online, so they also ask me about crypto, and because they know that I am interested in cryptocurrencies, and they ask me about good and reliable cryptos. And I want to say that, you know, like this is just a signal that the many people are getting more and more interested in cryptocurrencies, and probably a new wave of people joining the cryptocurrency world is on the way. And I want to say that, of course, I will just apply one, let's say, very common strategy to investing in the crypto, in the financial markets. Diversification. So just diversify, pick the top 10, let's say, cryptocurrency, or the top 15. And create a well-diversified portfolio. Of course, I would say that probably Bitcoin, for example, definitely is the key cryptocurrency, the flagman, the most reliable one, and definitely the biggest share, let's say, of each, let's say, passive investment should be allocated to Bitcoin. But probably it's nice to include also currencies such as Ethereum. Of course, Tether is pegged to the USD, that's why I will omit it, but Polkadot, and etc. So just have a look at these 15 top cryptocurrencies. And this is, once again, one of the most successful and reliable ways for investing in the financial markets. Well-diversified portfolio, including, let's say, 5 to 10 assets, among chosen among the top ones, the most reliable ones. Of course, if you want to make more risky investments, then you can try to find some other alternative coins, but this is very difficult task, to be honest, at least in my view. For passive investors, it's better to invest in the top cryptocurrencies. Once again, Bitcoin is definitely the leader, and the biggest chunk of investment should be allocated, at least in my view, to Bitcoin. But what I want to say is, of course, people, they become more and more interested, because everywhere you find such kind of news like big investor, Grayscale's inflows hit 3.3 billion and record-breaking fourth quarter, that JP Morgan, other big players, Guggenheim, Grayscale, former, for example, Michael Novogratz, former ex-Goldman Sachs banker, he also invests in cryptocurrency. So people, when they see such kind of news, when they check the prices, when they hear on a daily basis and media outlets about crypto, they become more and more interested, definitely. And once again, diversification, in my view, is one of the key to the long-run success. And I want to tell you, it's easy to make some kind of research in the internet. Just use some search engine and trying to find example or templates of such kind of investment portfolios. I mean, just visit the site of some fund investing in cryptocurrencies. For example, Galaxy Digital is one of the most famous ones. So check the site, have a look at what kind of cryptos they are buying. This is an example, for example, the Galaxy Crypto Index Fund. And you can see that this is, for example, the breakdown of their portfolio. 40% is allocated to Bitcoin, then 40% to in Ethereum. 9.6% of their portfolio is allocated to Litecoin. 7.5% to Bitcoin Cash and 2.9% to EOS. So I think that this is a very nice portfolio probably because Galaxy Digital has been quite successful for the last couple of years, actually since inception. You can check the fact sheets and etc. Let me click here and see how it looks like. Oh, this is a very, this is Bloomberg Galaxy Crypto Index. So this is how the Bloomberg, this index looks like. And I want to say that they have data where you can follow, let me check fund information, no, for free you can follow, let's say, the total amount of assets invested, the return on investment, and I want to say that they have achieved really very nice ROIs or return on investment. So I think that probably this is a good portfolio in my view. Also, I found earlier today another fund because I try to visit to check some of those most famous funds, and all of a sudden I saw this one and I did like it because, first of all, this is the first day I have ever encountered this fund, Sarson Funds, Real Clear Crypto. But they have many different, let's say, funds. So crypto in income fund, large coin fund, small coin fund, smart crypto 15 index, stable coin index. So they have really very interesting funds. Because if you check the first one, besides to investing in crypto, they also invest in, let's say, mining equipment, or probably they in such kind of, let's say, alternative way to earn crypto, you know, to make crypto, not only just by buying, but by investing in such kind of mining equipment and facilities. So this is really cool. But let me, for example, click on this large coin fund or the small coin fund. Actually, I open one of them and you can just have a look at the breakdown of their portfolio. So look, 57% is allocated to Bitcoin. Ethereum with 14%, XRP with 5%, Bitcoin Cash with 4%, Binance Coin, Polkadot, Chainlink, Cardano, Litecoin, EOS. So this is one of some of the key, let's say, cryptocurrencies that are within top 15 or within top 20, I would say, because EOS is the 16th biggest cryptocurrency at the moment. And for example, you can see that since inception, they have achieved a relatively, I would say, very high return on investment, that is close to 200%, keeping in mind that if they started to invest back in 2017, in the month of October, actually in the second half of October, they were very close to the all-time high, just 2 months away from all-time high. So it means that they bought at relatively high levels at that time. Of course, nowadays, if we compare the current levels with those levels, for example, let me just open the chart of the market cap of the cryptocurrency capitalization. Definitely, it looks like, yes, the current levels are significantly higher than back then. But within this part of, within this part of the chart, during the bear market, that local high used to be extremely high. So people used to say that those who invested here, they suffered a lot, and that's true. Probably they had to wait for quite some time to recover their investment. But at the end of the day, just have a look at these numbers, and we see that even such kind of investment turned out to be a really very successful one, with close to 200% since its inception. So, fellas, that's it for today. Once again, I just want to say that probably the best way for beginners and new people joining the cryptocurrency wave nowadays and interested in buying crypto, it would be nice to research some example of such kind of portfolios and create something similar, well-diversified portfolio, and just hodl it for a couple of years, and then you will see that at the end of the day, it will be really a nice investment, hopefully. That's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets, and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.